Hello, world. Lisa Friedrichsen here, your friend and computer science professor from Johnson County Community College, with another short screencast on javascript.info, the modern JavaScript tutorial. And we are down in section 2, working with JavaScript as it relates to HTML and CSS. And we're up to section 1.3, walking the DOM. Sometimes this is called traversing the DOM, because after all, if we're going to use JavaScript to manipulate text and elements and nodes on the web page, we need to know how to walk the DOM or move up and down in the web page. In our previous lesson, we learned that everything on the web page is a node. And we learned that there's three kinds of nodes. There's element nodes, there's text nodes that are both inside a paired element as well as after an element when there's an enter key or any spaces before the opening element. And the third type of node we learned about is a comment node. JavaScript.info diagrams how to move between the nodes using things such as parent node, next sibling, child nodes, last child, first child, previous sibling. And those words make sense when you think of an element having children. For example, the UL element is a child of body. The LI element is a child of UL. When you have a well-indented HTML file, it's a little bit easier to see the parents and the children. Let's go over to our JavaScript file and let's look at the document object and let's look at the body and let's look at its child node. And isn't this wonderful how Visual Studio shows you properties and methods as you're typing your code? This is part of IntelliSense, intelligent sensing of where you're at in your statement and giving you suggestions with these drop-down menus. So it helps us remember some things and find our way and write our statements faster. I'm going to do the document.body.childNode statement. And we also know from previous lessons that we can console log out anything that we want into the console to see it better. JavaScript.info likes to use alerts because you're already on that web page. But you know that I much prefer console.log to see information. So I'm going to use console.log and just surround this statement so that I can see the result of that in the console. I'm going to save and I'm going to refresh my web page. My console is already open. And when I console out the child nodes of the body of the document, I get four items: a text node, an ordered list node, another text node, and a script node. I can expand the node list and I can even expand each one of these nodes and see any of the properties or values of that node. And in this case, I've got a text node, an unordered list node, another text node, and a script node, and a text node below that. And let's look at that in the HTML. So from our previous lesson, here's our body. We know that anytime we hit enter after a tag and add space before the next element, we're going to get a text node out of that. Then here's my unordered list. My unordered list closes down here on line 26. After that, I've got another hit of an enter key and a little space before my next element script. And after my closing script, I've got the hit of an enter key, so that gives me my last text node. If we wanted to talk to one of these nodes, it would be very important to understand how to dig into this list and find the specific text or element that we want. And we can do that with some of these properties that this lesson speaks of. In addition, this lesson also tells us that we can navigate through the DOM using element-only navigation, and many of the properties that we use are very similar, only using the word element instead of node, list and identify the elements on the web page. For example, let's try and console log out document.body.childElements so that we can see the child elements only. So if we use that property and we save and refresh our page, we find undefined from line 5. So child elements, unfortunately, is not a property of the body, but that's where your IntelliSense can come in. If I do a dot and I type in the word element, I can see all the different methods which are identified with these little cubes and properties which are identified with these little boxes, because a property stores one attribute of the object. There's no element node, but there is child element count. So I could save that, refresh, and find out that from the body, there are only two elements as children. Again, if I go back to my HTML, I can see that. Here's the body. Here's my first child, the UL. And then here's my second child, the script. So knowing these properties from this lesson will help you navigate or walk the DOM, and we need to be able to go up and down inside the web page in order to identify exactly what we want to change and manipulate in our JavaScript. Thank you.